back, and if you're new here, welcome. I have got some catching up to do from the last one. So if you've seen the last video, you know that I talked about going back to my university to do a talk about how college students can create a safe space within themselves and remain connected to themselves through the college experience. And holy smokes, was it just absolutely amazing? Yes, it was so good. I drank up every bit of that experience. There was great body language happening, great eye contact, great questions. I mean, the engagement was amazing. It was so reaffirming that this is something I'm supposed to be talking about and continue getting into. To think that I'm not apprehensive to sharing and opening up and being vulnerable is kind of silly. I am a human being too, and I get scared of opening up and sharing and getting into this. But with that feeling that I had in experiencing the speech as I was telling and doing like back and forth conversation and being transparent and vulnerable in so many different ways, it was so gratifying. I mean, just immense gratitude. I went to lunch with a student afterwards with my past professor, and it was so cool to have a conversation with her, get to know her, her opening up about her experiences and just like seeing her crack open in a way she may not open up to other strangers, to other people that she didn't know. And so it was just so cool because it felt as though like we'd known each other before this and no idea who she is. There's some potential there to come back and talk about entrepreneurship as well and really going about it in a whole different way and highlighting these new ways of business that aren't really highlighted in the traditional way of the college experience. In closing that, I really want to highlight just in this vlog in general today, moving through the fear and the nerves no longer holding you back, because we are not available for that anymore. Why are we letting the fear overwhelm us from embodying who we are, who we want to become, and our dream life? Okay, and there's so many different layers to that, right? This is the process. This is why I show my process. It's not the same as many others. It's not going to be the same as yours. But I do think it's important to show that there are layers of that you have to pull back in order to get to the core and reach that dream life, because we hold so many fears of judgment, so many fears of success, fear of so many things. And so I want to talk about how we can move through the fear, and I'm going to be trickling in that through this vlog today, because I'm done. I'm ready for us to get into our dream life. I'm ready for us to jump in and for you to not hold back anymore, because you've got something so freaking special to offer to this world, and we're not available for that fear anymore. Another pup visit. This is Mr. Peanut. Hi, Peanut. Oh my gosh. Oh, he is a mega jumper. Do I have dirt in my face? That is quite possible. And then we have Mr. Freddy here. He is such a sweetie pie. He's a little bit older. Peanut is, Peanut's young, as he always wants to be in the face. But there's Freddy. Freddy.
Order here, I'm having these thoughts generating in my mind right now.
about how I've created these things and how I've brought this apparel line into fruition, this speak into fruition, and brought it to the space that I really wanted it to be. Is it perfectly aligned with what I want it to be? No. I do believe that we can hold this vision and this idea and get most of it to come into tangible fruition. And the rest of it is more of a surprise. I don't personally believe that it's ever exactly the way that we want, because there's things that need to be looked at and seen from the side of it not going exactly the way that you want. And so I want to break this down and how I got here and moved through the fear of being seen, being heard, putting myself out there, expressing myself, because a lot of times that's what's holding us back, right? The fear. The fear is a lot to hold. We have these fearful thoughts, these feelings that we are afraid of, and I just want to talk about how I personally got here. And I've been really reflecting with it, especially with my speech, because I didn't just like do this big like construction thing and like create this whole deal just like I learned in school. It's very different from what I learned in college. But how I went about it was I had this vision first. I had something that I was excited about, something that really got me feeling like, oh my gosh, I really need to do this. And the vision was so strong. And I held that vision. So first and foremost, I want you to think about this thing that you're dreaming about doing, or this thing you wanna do, but you're scared, or you're a lot scared, who knows, whatever you're experiencing. I want you to think about what you're afraid of. What in that thing are you afraid of? So for example, my speech, let's kind of use that. I'm afraid of it not going well. Okay, there's my acknowledgement. I'm afraid of it not going well. Okay, then step number two is look at what you are genuinely excited about in this thing that you are doing, this creative process. And for me, that exciting moment in my speech was to provide some support and love for these college students, support them in a way that they may have not been supported before. Feed them some information that will really help them move through their experience that they're having. And so that is something that I was really, really excited about. And then lastly is holding that vision that I was talking about. Holding that vision and bringing it to the front of your mind and holding that. Holding the excitement, holding the dream, holding the thing that you want to go after. Because it's the excitement that's gonna drive you towards what you want to bring into fruition. The fear isn't. That's going to take you right away from what you're really wanting to happen, right? Because if I went into my speech so freaking scared and brought those thoughts and feelings that I don't like to the forefront of my mind, then I would have stumbled my words. I would have not got my point across very well. And it wouldn't have brought the dream to life. It wouldn't have brought the thing to fruition. I held that excitement all the way through. So from the beginning of literally writing out my speech, the points that I want to talk about, the things that I believe were going to resonate with them the most. I really pulled from obviously my own experience and knowledge, but held like really what I wanted to create. I really allowed myself to be in that energy before it even happened. You know, we can't just be like, oh, yep, and just like that. Absolutely not. We have to work through these barriers to get there in order to believe in ourselves to make it come into fruition. And it's such a beautiful thing. These are the stepping stones. This is a moment of exploration, a moment to see what really gets you excited, what lights you up, and to really expand on what you can do. And if it takes trial and error, great. You know, bringing that excitement to the forefront of your mind will drive you exactly where you need to be. And I'm now trickling that into our Christmas party. Cooper and I are doing a Christmas party. We've got Christmas up in here. I'm so excited. We are doing 12 games of Christmas. We are having lots of snacks, yummy drinks. I'm super excited. It's going to be a really great time. So you're going to join me on the Christmas festivities of getting it ready. And I'm going to be showing you in the next video this wonderful party that we're having and all the Christmas festivities that we're doing, because we're going to the Nutcracker. We're going to do some Christmas light things. We're having our Christmas party. We have all these different Christmas to-dos that I'm so excited to bring you along with me, because my Christmas is looking a bit different this year, and I'm here to flood the joy for myself and others who may not be having the same Christmas as they had before also. So it's really cool to provide that for myself, Cooper, and all of our friends to really bring the Christmas joy to life and really bring back that kind of like kid feeling that we had before, you know, being adults. And on that note, I need to get back to packaging these, and I will be taking them to the post office today. So yay, super excited. Back to little packaging grind. So speaking of visions and bringing something to life, Cooper and I are having a wonderful, fun Christmas party this year. I'm so freaking excited to do that. Fully ready to bring in joy, fulfillment, good time mode into this apartment. And so we're doing a few different things. So first of all, we're doing a costume party. Everybody that comes is supposed to dress up as a Christmas item. And we're also doing, of course, a bunch of snacks, little fun Christmas drinks. Most importantly, we are doing 12 games of Christmas. And so I'm going to gather up the stuff that I have, start taking inventory of what we have, what we need, and start writing these 12 games of Christmas on the board here to make it look fancy and check through all of our Christmas games, because this is gonna kind of be our tournament board. So, super excited, gonna design it, get creative. We're gonna bring this vision to life, and you're coming right along with me. While you plan the thing that you're gonna do, you wanna be able to like really embody it, right? You're gonna literally be it. So I'm wearing these fun little lights all by myself as I create this cool tournament board here. But yeah, we finally got them all number ordered, which ones we wanna do first, as far as like being really strategic about what we want to experience as we go down the tournament board. And since I can't use my phone and record at the same time, enjoy my Christmas decorations that I have in here and just admire them. And I'll put our little quirky stuff, because some of our Christmas stuff has some dysfunction and some cute memories, so check it out. I am on my way, I'm in motion. Let's go to the ocean, yeah, let's go out. Without freezing, yeah, isn't that amazing? In Christmas times, we'll be chilling and having a good, good time. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling or the windows in the rain is falling. It will always be Christmas. Mission kind of complete. We've still got some things to do for this Christmas party, but I did get my tournament board set up. I have all of our games up there. I have the lines for who's gonna win the prizes, and that's gonna be super fun. And yes, I did take off my lights because I started drawing on there and my perfectionism started to come in and they were kind of annoying me, so I needed to take them off so I could ease my annoyance. That is complete. I've got my list of things that I need to get for the games, for the food, everything that we're doing with that. And luckily we have a lot of the stuff here, so not a whole lot left to get. But oh my gosh, I'm super duper excited. I can't wait to bring you along, because of course I'm gonna show you what the games are. Of course I'm gonna show you the party, because it's gonna be a good time. And who would I to show you all this Christmas stuff and not show you what we're doing? I'm so grateful that you are here today with me. I'm so excited to take you along this Christmas journey for this next vlog, seeing the Christmas. Cooper and I are going to the Nutcracker. We're gonna be doing some other Christmas festivities that I'm taking you along with me, because we've got to experience this Christmas joy together. And as a recap from today's whole shebang, hold that freaking vision for your idea, your business idea, your creativeness, the party, the speech, the whatever it is for you, the building, the sewing, the making, whatever that is, hold that vision so tightly, because it's through that vision that you hold, through the fears, through the doubts, that really get you to the place that you want to be. And that's how it really comes into fruition. And it's so incredible to just remember that when you have that vision, it's already yours, it's already there. That thing that you hold inside of you, that vision, it wants you so badly. It wants you. And when you hold that vision through the creation process, the fear can fade and the dream can manifest. I thank you so much for watching, and as always, I love you. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling or the windows in the rain is pouring, it will always be Christmas in my heart. Santa's coming to visit. No, he wouldn't be.